Okay, so let's be real for a second. Seek first the kingdom of God sounds great on a Sunday morning, right? But out here in the real world, like Monday through Friday, with deadlines and carpools and just life happening, it can feel a bit like, what does that even fit in?
It's a real tension, isn't it?
It
We
is.
feel it too, that pull between the urgent and the important, the eternal.
Right.
But that's why this deep dive is so timely. We're
Absolutely.
unpacking this incredible sermon from Pastor Dr. Jerry Udo. He really gets to the heart of this struggle.
And you know, I always say you've got this amazing gift
Oh, stop.
of like connecting those dots. You find the aha moments that I think most of us miss.
Well, we'll see about that.
So let's dive in
Let's do it.
and see what practical wisdom we can pull out from the sermon.
Well, one of the first things that struck me is that Pastor Udo, he starts by addressing this tension head on.
Okay.
He's not pretending that this is easy or that we can just magically add seeking the kingdom to our to-do lists.
Right, like it's another errand. It's
Exactly.
a whole different way of seeing things.
It really is about a shift in perspective. I think that's why he emphasizes that word first, seek ye first the
Yeah.
kingdom of God. It's about making it the lens through which we view everything else.
Okay, that's helpful. But before we even get to the seeking part, I think we need to define what are we even talking about here? The
Absolutely.
kingdom of God can feel, I don't know, kind of abstract.
Oh, absolutely. And Pastor Rito addresses that right away. He reminds us that the kingdom, it's not some far-off future or a gated community in the clouds.
Not earning our way in by being good.
No heavenly reward points here.
Okay, good.
He quotes Psalm 103:18. The Lord hath prepared his throne in the heavens, and his kingdom ruleth over all.
Okay.
It's recognizing that God's reign, it's already here.
Right here, right now?
It's active.
Yeah.
It encompasses all of life.
So the kingdom is less about a place and more about God's active presence and rule.
You got it. And what's even more fascinating is how he connects this to our individual lives.
Oh, okay. How so?
He talks about us being a microcosm of the kingdom.
Microcosm. That sounds a little
Yeah,
heady.
a little bit, but it's a really, really powerful idea.
Okay, I'm unpack that for me.
So, you as an individual, you are a reflection of God's kingdom. The transformation starts within you and then it ripples outward.
So it's not about waiting for some big external event, the kingdom coming.
Right.
It's about letting God's reign start
Right here,
in our hearts.
in your own life,
Right?
right
Wow.
now. And this is where things get practical.
Okay, good, because I need practical.
Me too. Pastor Udo, he outlines five specific steps we can take.
I like steps.
Yeah, me too. To seek first the kingdom, to align our lives with God's rule.
Okay, so step number one, hit me.
Step one is to be kingdom-minded.
Okay, kingdom-minded. I like the sound of
Sounds good, right?
it. But practically speaking, I mean, how does that actually work
Yeah.
when you're juggling work and family and all the things?
Exactly. Well, Pastor Udo, he says being kingdom-minded means we shift our focus
Okay.
from our own immediate needs and wants to God's priorities. It's asking ourselves, okay, how can I bring the values of God's kingdom into this situation?
So it's like a filter then,
Yeah.
right?
Yeah, like a filter.
Instead of just reacting based on, what I want, it's trying to see things from God's perspective.
That's a great way to put it. And
Yeah.
he uses this really interesting financial example to kind of illustrate this point.
Okay.
He talks about someone who, they'll drop $3,000 on a designer handbag without blinking an eye,
Okay.
but they hesitate to put more than $5 in the offering plate at church.
Oof, that one hits a little close to home.
Yeah.
But I get it, right? It's so easy to get caught up in our own stuff and lose sight of what really matters.
Absolutely. And it makes you think, right?
Yeah.
What would our spending habits look like
Right.
if we were really, truly kingdom-minded?
If we put God's kingdom ab above our own wants.
Where would our resources go?
Yeah.
What would we prioritize?
Okay, that's a good question to ponder. I'm gonna need to think about that one for a minute.
Yeah.
Okay, so we've got this kingdom mindset filter supposedly in place.
Okay.
What's the next step in seeking the kingdom?
Well, step two, it might sound a bit intimidating at first.
Okay, hit me.
He calls us to present your body as a living sacrifice unto the Lord.
Living sacrifice. I know that sounds a little intense. I'm
Yeah.
picturing like altars and fire, Yeah. Old Testament stuff.
Yeah.
But I'm guessing he's not talking about literal, like, sacrifices, right?
No, no, no. Yeah. You don't have to go find a lamb or anything.
Okay, good.
It's more about a surrender of our will, a commitment to aligning our lives with God's purposes.
Mm.
But I get why that phrase makes people a little uncomfortable.
Yeah, it kind of makes you squirm a bit. Yeah. Like, do I have to be perfect then? Because, spoiler alert, I'm not.
Yeah, that's the question, right?
Like, are we setting ourselves up for just constant guilt?
Right.
And discouragement.
And that's something that Pastor Udo addresses directly. Since, you know, yes, striving for holiness is important, but it's not about achieving sinless perfection.
Okay, that makes me feel a little bit better.
Yeah.
So it's not about beating ourselves up for every little mistake.
No, it's about recognizing that we don't belong to ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
We belong to God.
Okay. So our lives are a gift.
Yes.
And we should be living them in a way that honors him.
Exactly. Mm. And, you know, it's about making choices that reflect that.
Yeah.
It's resisting intentional sin.
Right.
Turning away from things that we know are wrong or against God's will.
So it's both. Mm. It's striving for that holiness, but also giving ourselves grace.
Yes.
When we mess up.
Yes. It's about progress, not perfection.
Okay.
It's a journey.
Yeah.
That we're on with God.
Okay, I like that. I'm feeling a little bit better about the living sacrifice thing.
Okay.
So, mindset shift, surrender. What's next?
Okay, well, this one might challenge some of our deeply ingrained assumptions, especially, I think, in Western culture.
Okay, lay it on me.
Okay, he calls us to place God's work above our own work.
Ooh, now that one sounds a little tough.
Yeah.
Does that mean I have to quit my job and become a missionary?
Not necessarily, but it definitely challenges us to think about our priorities.
Yeah.
And to be honest, this is something I've wrestled with myself.
Mm-hmm.
Pastor Udo doesn't mince words. He quotes Luke 14.26.
Oh, boy.
If any man come to me and hate not his father and mother and wife and children and brethren and sisters, yea, and his own life also, he cannot be my disciple.
Hate is a strong word.
Yes, it is.
Especially today when, you know, family and personal fulfillment, those are like the top values.
Yeah, no, it's jarring. But Pastor Udo, he explains that the hate here, it's not about literal hatred or neglecting your responsibilities. It's about prioritizing.
Mm-hmm.
It's about recognizing that our relationship with God, that has to be the foundation for everything else.
So it's not loving our families less.
No.
It's loving God more.
Yes.
Okay.
And understanding that when that relationship is right, everything else, it falls into place.
So the love for our families, our work, it all flows from that.
From that central source, yes.
Okay. Yeah.
It's not about neglecting our earthly responsibilities, but it's about making sure that our relationship with God is the driving force.
Yeah. It's like when our priorities are aligned with God's kingdom, then everything else can find its proper place.
Exactly.
Okay. I'm starting to see the bigger picture here.
Good.
It's like reorienting our whole lives around God's kingdom. Okay, so we've covered three steps. What's next on this journey of seeking first the kingdom?
Okay, well, step number four has to do with our relationship with resources, with possessions.
Okay.
It's understanding that we are stewards, not owners.
Steward.
Yeah.
Like someone who manages an estate.
Exactly.
I don't know. I'm not sure I see the connection.
Okay. Think of it this way. Everything we have, our time, talents, money, possessions, they don't ultimately belong to us.
Okay.
They're entrusted to us by God to be used for his purposes.
So it's not about holding on tight.
No.
To what we have, but recognizing that it's all on loan.
It's a gift.
Yeah.
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 And that we're accountable for how we use it.
Absolutely. And Pastor Udo, he points out a common pitfall.
Oh, I'm sure I've fallen into it.
Especially in a society that values individual achievement.
Mm-hmm.
Hard work, right? We think, well, I earn this. I deserve to spend it however I want.
Yeah, yeah. It's easy to forget that even the ability to work comes from God.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. And he reminds us that true stewardship, it starts with gratitude.
Okay.
Recognizing that everything is a gift from God. And that cultivates a heart of generosity.
So less about guilt, more about a joyful generosity.
Yes. And that generosity, it goes beyond just finances.
Right. Yeah.
It's about time and talents and energy. It's about using all of it to b- bless others and to advance God's kingdom.
Okay, so seeing everything through that lens of stewardship, we're managers, we've been entrusted with these resources. Okay, four down. What's the last piece of this kingdom-seeking puzzle?
Okay. This one might be the most challenging, especially in a world that often celebrates comfort and ease.
Okay, I have a feeling I know where this is going.
He talks about being willing to suffer persecution for the sake of the kingdom.
Yeah, see? I knew it. Okay, honestly. Who wants to sign up for hardship?
I know, it's a natural response. We want the blessings, we want the rewards, but persecution? Not so much.
No, thank you. But how do we reconcile this? This call to follow Jesus, but with the possibility of facing opposition or even suffering? I mean, how does that work?
Well, Pastor Udo, he acknowledges this is a hard truth, but it's a truth that Jesus himself spoke about.
Yeah, he did warn his disciples that following him wouldn't exactly be a walk in the park.
Right. And so this isn't just some theoretical concept. This is lived reality.
Mm-hmm.
For many Christians throughout history and even today.
Okay, so I guess we need to clarify what we mean by persecution. It's not just about, you know, being thrown to the lions.
Right? No, it can take many forms.
So it could be more subtle, like being excluded.
Yes.
Or facing discrimination at work because of your faith.
Exactly.
Or even opposition from family.
It can even be those closest to us.
So it's about being prepared then for resistance.
Yes.
Hardship. Because of our commitment to Christ.
And Pastor Udo reminds us that we're not alone in this. He points to the example of Job.
Job, okay, yeah.
Who endured unimaginable suffering.
Lost everything. Family, his wealth, his health.
And yet never cursed God.
It's a powerful reminder, though, that even when we don't understand, even when it's hard.
Yes.
God is there.
He's with us.
In the midst of it.
He's with us.
Okay, that gives me a whole new perspective on this persecution thing. Not seeking it out, but being prepared.
Yes.
Facing it with grace.
Yes.
Trusting God to sustain us.
And that leads us perfectly into the next part of our deep dive, where we'll explore this idea of seeking the kingdom and how it connects to spiritual warfare.
Okay, this is getting really interesting. We're going to take a quick break, but we'll be right back to continue unpacking this powerful message from Pastor Udo.
So before the break, we were talking about persecution, and, you know, it's not exactly a fun topic.
No.
But it's something that Pastor Udo doesn't shy away from.
And, you know, what really struck me is how he describes Christians as being part of God's, like, end time army.
It's a powerful image, isn't it?
It is. It makes you think about seeking the kingdom. It's not just about being, you know, personally transformed or being pious.
Mm-hmm.
It's about actively engaging in a spiritual battle.
Yes.
Okay, now that sounds intense. I'm picturing armor and combat training, but how does that translate to, like, everyday life? What does it mean to be a warrior for the kingdom, practically speaking?
Well, I think it starts by recognizing that there are forces at work in the world that oppose God's will, that oppose his kingdom.
Okay.
Pastor Udo, he references Jeremiah 51.20, where God says, "Thou art my battle axe and weapons of war. For with thee will I break in pieces nations, and with thee will I destroy kingdoms."
Wow, that's some pretty strong language. So are we talking about literal battles here, like storming enemy castles and fighting dragons?
Not literally, of course.
Okay.
But there's definitely a sense of spiritual warfare.
Okay.
It's about confronting the forces of darkness that manifest in our own lives,
mm-hmm,
and in the world around us.
So it's more about combating, like, negativity and injustice and things that go against God's will.
Exactly. The weapons that we use in this battle, they're spiritual weapons.
Okay.
Pastor Udo emphasizes prayer, fasting, staying rooted in God's word.
It's like we've been given this incredible arsenal, but we've kind of forgotten how to use it.
That's a great way to put it. He even talks about, he laments the lack of miracles in many churches today,
mm-hmm,
suggesting that it's because we've become complacent.
Yeah.
We've grown accustomed to a comfortable, predictable Christianity that avoids confrontation.
So it's about reclaiming that power, that authority we have in Christ.
Yeah.
Stepping out in faith, engaging in this spiritual battle.
Absolutely. It's about being proactive, not just, you know, sitting back and hoping for the best. It's taking a stand against evil, even in its small, subtle forms.
You know, it makes me think about those moments when I'm, you know, tempted to gossip or give in to fear and anxiety,
yeah,
or to just ignore injustice happening around me. Maybe those are battlegrounds too.
Mm.
Those little choices where we're either aligning ourselves with God's kingdom or giving in to those forces that oppose it.
That's such a great insight. And it highlights how this idea of spiritual warfare connects to those five steps.
Oh, yeah.
That we were talking about earlier. It's about bringing that kingdom mindset to every situation, presenting ourselves as living sacrifices, prioritizing God's work, and understanding that we're stewards.
So all of these things, these different aspects of seeking the kingdom, they come together in this call to be warriors, to be actively engaged in advancing God's will in the world.
Exactly. And I think that's what makes this message so powerful. It's not just about personal piety or escaping to heaven when we die. It's about being agents of transformation in the here and now.
It's about like bringing heaven to earth.
Yes.
Like Jesus taught us to pray.
And that can be incredibly challenging.
Yeah.
Especially when the world feels so chaotic and hostile to God's ways. But as Pastor Udo reminds us, we're not fighting this battle alone.
So we don't have to be like, you know, superheroes trying to save the world in our own strength.
No, not at all. It's about recognizing we're part of God's army.
Mm-hmm.
We have his power backing us up.
And that makes me think of that quote from Pastor Udo, that those who do know their God shall be strong and do exploits.
Yes. And it emphasizes that it all starts with knowing God.
Mm-hmm.
Not just knowing about him, but having that deep, intimate relationship with him.
Because it's in that relationship, isn't it? Experiencing his love and power, that we find that strength and courage.
Yes.
To face those battles, big and small.
Absolutely. And it connects back to that idea of being a microcosm of the kingdom.
Okay.
The transformation begins within us,
mm-hmm.
in our hearts and minds.
So as we surrender to God's rule,
yes.
allow him to work in us,
mm.
then we become equipped to be those warriors, those agents of change.
Exactly. And it's not just about fighting against something.
Yeah.
It's about fighting for something.
Okay.
For the values and the principles of God's kingdom.
To be established in our lives.
Yes.
And in the world.
Exactly. And that's what makes it so inspiring.
Mm.
It's not just about escaping to heaven.
Mm-hmm.
It's about making a difference here and now.
Yeah.
It's about partnering with God.
Yeah. To bring about his purposes in the world.
It makes me think about those financial examples.
Oh, yeah.
That Pastor Udo uses.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just about how much money we give.
Right.
But the heart behind it.
Yeah.
Seeing those resources as tools.
Yeah.
For kingdom purposes.
It reminds me of that story about the woman who gave just a few coins.
Yes. The widow's mite.
Yeah, yeah.
And even though it was small, Jesus commended her because she gave everything.
It was a sacrifice.
It was a sacrifice of love and devotion.
It's not about the amount. It's about that attitude.
Yes.
The willingness to give sacrificially.
And that applies to more than just finances.
Okay.
It's about our time, our talents, our energy.
To those things that align with God's kingdom.
Yeah.
So it's asking, how can I use what I have to make a difference, to bring healing, to promote justice? To share God's love.
Well said. And I think that leads to an important question. Mm-hmm. What does it mean to be a builder of the kingdom
mm-hmm.
in our everyday lives? What are the practical ways that we can invest in God's kingdom? Be agents of transformation.
That's a great question. I think that's going to require some honest reflection and maybe even some brainstorming. Listeners, we'll be back after a quick break to delve into that question and explore some practical ways we can be kingdom builders in our everyday lives. Welcome back, everyone. So before the break, we were talking about being not just warriors in God's kingdom, but builders too.
Yes.
And that honestly feels a lot more hopeful.
It does, doesn't it?
Less about fighting
and
more about creating something beautiful, something lasting.
It's a powerful shift. Yeah.
It is, but it also begs the question, what does that actually look like? Hmm. How do we move beyond the abstract and actually become those kingdom builders mm-hmm. in our everyday lives?
Well, I think it starts with asking ourselves some honest questions.
Right.
Where do I see brokenness in the world?
Mm-hmm.
Where is there a need for healing?
Okay.
Justice for restoration.
So it's about paying attention, right? Opening our eyes to the needs around us.
Exactly. And then asking, how can I use what I have, my time, my talents, my resources, to actually make a difference?
You know, it makes me think about that quote from Pastor Udo, "Those who do know their God shall be strong and do exploits." It's not just about knowing the right things theologically.
Right.
It's about knowing God personally, experiencing his power, his love, and that compels us to action.
That's such a crucial point because, you know, when we truly know God, it transforms us from the inside out.
It changes everything.
It does. It shapes our desires, our priorities, our passions.
So the more we know God, the more we'll naturally want to be part of his work in the world.
It becomes less about duty or obligation.
Yeah.
and more about a joyful response to his love.
It makes me think about those financial examples
Pastor Udo was using. He wasn't just trying to make us feel guilty about giving more.
No.
He was challenging us to check our hearts.
To see if our spending habits really reflect a kingdom mindset.
Yeah, yeah. And that story he shared about the woman who gave just a few coins.
Yes, the widow's mite.
Powerful.
Jesus commended her, not because of the amount, but because she gave sacrificially.
It came from a place of love.
Out of a heart of love and devotion.
It's not about the size of the gift. It's about the heart.
Exactly. And that same principle applies to every area of kingdom building.
Mm.
It's about offering ourselves.
Okay.
Our time, our talents, our resources, but with a heart of love, a desire to see God's will done.
So maybe it's, you know, volunteering.
Yes.
Mentoring a young person.
Yes.
Using our creative talents to bring beauty into the world.
Yes.
Even having those tough conversations.
Yes.
With loved ones who don't know God. Those are all beautiful examples. It's about taking those seemingly small steps, those acts of love and service, and recognizing their eternal significance.
It's those ordinary moments, I think, where God's kingdom can break through.
Absolutely. And it reminds me of something that Pastor Udo said toward the end of the sermon.
Yeah.
He talked about being not just warriors, but watchmen as well.
Oh, interesting. Watchmen. What does he mean by that?
He used the analogy of, you know, a watchman standing on the city walls.
Okay, yeah.
Keeping an eye out for danger, sounding the alarm when necessary.
So being alert, paying attention.
Yes.
To what's happening around us.
But it's also about being proactive and protecting what is precious, what's good, what's true.
So not just fighting off attacks, but actively nurturing the things that promote God's kingdom.
Exactly. It's about being guardians of truth, of justice, of compassion.
Makes me think about the prophets in the Old Testament speaking truth to power.
Yes.
Challenging the status quo.
Yes. And it highlights the courage it takes.
Mm-hmm.
The conviction it takes to be a watchman, to be a voice for God's kingdom.
Because the world doesn't always want to hear it.
It doesn't. It's about being willing to stand out.
Yeah.
Be different. To risk rejection.
Yeah.
Even persecution for what's right.
And that brings us back to that last step we talked about.
Yes.
The willingness to suffer for the kingdom. Sobering, but also, I don't know, it speaks to the power of God's love.
It does. Because when we are truly captivated by God's kingdom,
mm-hmm.
when we've experienced his grace,
yeah.
it compels us to stand firm, even when it's hard.
You know, it makes me think of that image Pastor Udo used at the end of his sermon.
Oh, yes.
The image of childbirth.
Powerful, isn't it?
It is. He talked about the pain, the struggle.
Yes.
That ultimately leads to new life. So is he saying that kingdom building, seeing God's will done, it often involves suffering?
Yes. But it's a redemptive suffering.
Okay.
It's a pain that produces something beautiful.
Like a seed breaking through the hard ground.
Yes. There's struggle, but there's incredible potential.
As we seek first the kingdom, as we align our lives with God's will, we can trust that he's going to use even those hard times.
Jesus.
For good.
For good. For his glory.
Wow. This deep dive has been, I don't know, eye-opening for me. It's challenged me to rethink my priorities.
I'm so glad.
To really embrace that call to be a warrior, a builder, a watchman for God's kingdom.
That's beautiful. And as we wrap up, I want to leave you with a final thought from Pastor Udo that really stayed with me. He said, everything in life has a season.
Oh, I love that. It reminds me of Ecclesiastes. To everything there is a season.
Exactly. And he connected it to seeking the kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
He talked about, you know, seasons of sowing and reaping, of joy and sorrow, of peace and persecution.
So it's not always going to be easy.
Yeah.
But there's a purpose.
There is. And even when it's hard, we can trust that God is working all things together for good.
For those who love him.
For those who love him.
That gives me hope. That even when things are uncertain, when it's a challenge, God is at work. And he invites us to be a part of it.
To partner with him.
To partner with him. So as we go into this next week, let's remember that call to be warriors, builders, watchmen.
Yes.
Let's embrace those seasons of growth.
Even the tough ones.
Even the tough ones.
Mm-hmm.
And trust that God is using them to shape us.
To prepare us for greater things.
Well, thank you all for joining us on this deep dive into seeking first the kingdom of God. We hope it's inspired you to reevaluate your priorities and to embrace the adventure of partnering with God.
In his kingdom.
In his kingdom.
Hey.
Right here. Right now.
And may you be filled with his strength and wisdom as you go.